What's going on? It's Machanga back with another video. There's going to be a lot of exciting laptop releases in 2021 with new Intel and AMD processors, but some really great options are already available for purchase. When I consider all-around functionality for home use by the entire family, for school and working from home or the office, the HP Envy line of laptops offers a nice balance between price and performance. Anything I mentioned in this video will have affiliate links listed below in the description, including updated pricing. This is my review of the HP Envy 17. I don't usually review 17-inch laptops, but there is a special place in a lot of homes for a machine of this size. First, let's get the specs out of the way. My review unit is running the 11th Gen Intel Core i7-1165G7 with the NVIDIA MX450 GPU. There's 16 gigs of DDR4 RAM, a 512GB NVMe SSD, along with 32GB of Intel Optane memory. Now, if you were looking at the Envy 15 and wondering if this is just a bigger version of that laptop, it is not. One key difference to make note of is the much more powerful dedicated graphics card in the Envy 15. If you plan to do more than just a little occasional gaming, you will definitely appreciate the RTX 2060 Max-Q in that laptop. We only get the MX450 here, and I'll talk about performance, including gaming, in a moment. Rounding out the specs, we do have Wi-Fi 6 and Bluetooth 5 on board, so connectivity is fast and file transfer speeds are great. The display is big and it's gorgeous. This is a 17.3-inch 60Hz IPS display with a resolution of 3840 by 2160 or 4K. I almost always opt for the 4K screen when configuring a laptop for my own use, but you can get this machine with a 1920 by 1080 display instead, and that will definitely help save some battery life. This is a touchscreen, and we get nice, vibrant colors, good contrast, and deep blacks. As far as brightness goes, it measured in right below 400 nits, which isn't anything to get too excited about, but indoors, I found it to be more than adequate even with this glossy finish. You're not going to be able to compete with direct sunlight, so keep that in mind if you plan to use this outside. At 100% sRGB, it's not just pretty, but it's also accurate. If you're a content creator working in Photoshop, Lightroom, or even Premiere Pro, you should be happy with the image results here. With a screen this large, I think entertainment will be a big part of the daily use of this laptop. Everything looks good on this Envy 17. If I had to nitpick and find something to complain about, I would like even slimmer bezels to really get that immersive viewing experience. I know some people only want OLED, but I'm not one of those people. Now, my first impression right out of the box was, wow, it's big, but it's not clunky. It looks and feels high-end with a premium modern design. You can get this laptop in natural silver, but I wanted something a little bit more unique. This is Nightfall Black with modern walnut. I'm sorry, but it looks stunning. It's an all-metal chassis with this authentic wood palm rest. You can see and feel that natural wood grain. Upstairs in my studio, I have several walnut desktops, so this fits in perfectly. It's just a classic combo of black and walnut. You might expect it to feel rough or even uncomfortable to use, but it's not. It feels smooth and really refined. The trackpad doesn't suffer at all and gestures work just fine. I don't think anyone expects a 17-inch laptop to be lightweight, so the 6.02 pounds was no surprise to me. I imagine most people buying this laptop want it for use in a family setting or an office setting placed on a desk or a table. It feels like it'll hold up to everyday long-term use. According to HP, this wood design was formulated not to splinter or crack. The hinge isn't a 360-degree version, but it feels rigid and sturdy with no creaks. I imagine durability won't be an issue if I base it on my previous experience with HP laptops. Okay, so what ports do we get? On the right, we have the power port, two USB 3.2 Type-A ports, and the full-size SD card reader, which I always prefer over the micro SD card slot. Moving to the left side, there's another USB 3.2 Type-A port that can charge other devices even while the laptop is asleep, a HDMI 2.0 port, the headphone microphone combo jack, and a USB 3.2 Type-C port capable of power delivery, data transfer, and display out. Now, this USB-C port is not Thunderbolt 3 or 4. This port selection is more than adequate for most consumers I feel that this machine is targeted to, and other other than the lack of Thunderbolt support for my workflow, I have no complaints. The keyboard here is black with a white backlight. The usual silver keys with white backlighting aren't my favorite combination, and I find these much easier to view in different lighting environments. It's full size with the number pad, which is another reason to choose a 17-inch laptop. It's a comfortable keyboard with well-spaced keys and good key travel. You get good tactile feedback. I find it to be better than the keyboard on the MacBook Pro, and not as good as the one on my ThinkPad workstation. Overall, it's big, it's good, and it's not cramped for long typing sessions. I already mentioned the wood trackpad feels smooth and it's a good size. It's using precision drivers and it's been responsive with no hiccups thus far. Above the display, there's the 720p webcam. I think a lot more people are using a webcam in current times, and this one is good enough for Zoom calls, Google Meets, and whatever video chats you need to be a part of. It has the camera shutter for privacy and the integrated dual array microphone, so your voice comes through loud and clear. It's a laptop webcam with a normal level of quality and no Windows Hello technology, so nothing spectacular, but not a potato either. For a secure way to log into the laptop, you can use the fingerprint reader here on the keyboard. In my testing, it's been accurate and fast enough. Before we move on to performance, the speakers on this machine sound really good. It's a dual speaker system by Bang & Olufsen. They have great clarity and good bass response. Using these in a central location for media consumption should be an overall pleasant experience. For watching Netflix, YouTube videos, or just listening to music, these get the job done. A pretty laptop is nothing if the performance falls apart. This HP Envy 17 with the 11th gen Intel Core i7 CPU and NVIDIA MX 40 GPU holds up really well. I'll put up some benchmarks for those that want to see numbers, but in my real world use, this laptop performed good in all the tasks I threw at it. Now, this isn't a video editing workhorse or a gaming laptop, and I'll link some better options in the video description if that's your primary focus, but for everyday tasks, virtual academy, using the Microsoft suite of applications, editing photos, light video editing, and just browsing the web, this is a capable and affordable machine. Just because there isn't a RTX graphics card inside doesn't mean you can't game on the Envy 17. On low settings and 1080p, we got some decent frame rates. I found this laptop to be pretty versatile, and it should be a great fit for a mobile office machine if you don't mind the weight. Before we wrap up, let's talk briefly about the battery life and thermals. It's a big laptop with a big screen. I usually get around 4 hours of battery life, but I do believe that if you opt for the full HD panel instead of this 4K screen, you should get around 5 hours. It's a 55 watt hour battery and it charges with a 65 watt power adapter. You can go from 0 to 50% in about 45 minutes. It's a long enough runtime for my needs since this has been a mostly stationary laptop. Thermal performance has been good and throttling is kept to a minimum with the dual fans inside. Tiger Lake is built to be more efficient and I think it really works well in this larger chassis. It never got uncomfortable to the touch in my hand or on my lap. And the fans didn't ramp up too loudly. So, do I recommend the HP Envy 17 with the latest Intel processor? Yes, I do. Would I like an AMD variant? Absolutely, and my fingers are crossed that it's coming soon. This is a nice, large laptop that should meet the needs of a lot of consumers that don't need the beefiest graphics on the market. As a student that's learning and working from home, this is an easy recommendation. The design is just gorgeous and premium, the performance is good, the speakers are good. The display is color accurate and beautiful. I can get work done, plus do a little gaming if I want to. Sure, I mean, Thunderbolt 3 or 4 would have been nice, but it's just not a deal breaker for me. As usual, all the affiliate links, including updated pricing, will be listed below in the video description. I would love to hear your thoughts about this laptop. If you like this video, hit the like button. If you feel like it, jump down in the comment section and let me know you like it. If you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe and make sure you tap the bell icon so you'll be notified every time I post a new video. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one.